Now, the protests throughout the summer led to lawmakers creating a task force on racial disparities. Capitol Bureau Chief A.J. Bhayatpour is here now with the bills that have come from the group so far, including a series scheduled to be heard tomorrow. A.J.
Well, it started with some of the demands made by protesters marching up and down State Street is now leading to some action a short distance away at the state capitol. The Assembly's Committee on Criminal Justice will hold a public hearing tomorrow on 7 police reform bills. That's in addition to 5 other bills that have already passed the full Senate. Now, the bills being heard tomorrow by that committee include measures that would require new cops to undergo psychological exams, would make departments report when they use no-knock search warrants, mandate that officers are drug tested after they're involved in a deadly incident, and provide more money for body cameras statewide. Representative Sheila Stubbs is a co-chair of this task force. She says she wants all of the bills on Governor Evers' desk by next month.
I don't want to fail, and I don't want to continue to fail our communities and to fail anyone else that's within the state of Wisconsin. So my desire is just to have this done by June.
Some of you might recall the task force had long struggled with how to reach an agreement on how to define excessive force. Well, the group, which includes police officials and protesters, found a compromise last week. That definition of excessive force will include the phrase objective reasonableness. Now, that's a phrase that comes from Supreme Court precedent. That's a phrase that police have favored. Protesters pushed for an addition to that, and there is one. That definition will also include whether officers acted with protection of the sanctity of life at the forefront of their actions.